And in this problem, we have a 40-60 mixture of water and benzene that is to be evaporated, so it's initially a liquid, and a heat exchanger operating at 3/4 of an atmosphere. The entering mixture is at a temperature of 50 degrees C, and we're going to assume ideal gas and ideal solution behavior, which means we're assuming Raoult's law behavior. And what we want to determine is how much heat is going to need to be supplied in a continuous flow process. The energy balance for this problem then will be that delta H across our heat exchanger will be equal to Q. And so we're going to be having an initial state one that is a liquid. We know the temperature is 50 degrees C. The pressure is 0.75 atmospheres, and it has a mole fraction for benzene, the more volatile component, which I'll call A, of 0.60, with the remainder being water. And furthermore, we know that we can treat this as an ideal solution. Coming out of the heat exchanger, after we add the heat to do the vaporization, we're going to have a state 2 that is an ideal gas. The temperature is unknown, and it's going to be equal to the temperature of the dew point. All right, so at the dew point, we'll have just evaporated all of the mixture, as we'll show in just a minute. But that's an unknown number. All right, but we do know the pressure, and we know the composition. So the pressure is equal to P1, and our XA value doesn't change. It's just that it becomes YA. So let's look at how this looks on a Txy diagram. We see that when we draw the phase envelope, that we start with a 92 degrees C temperature, and this is the saturation temperature for component B, which is water. Whereas 71 degrees C on the right-hand side, where we have pure component A, which is benzene, is Tsat for component A. All right, and these can be looked up in tables. I actually determined these values from the Antoine equation, and the values for the Antoine equation that you need, the parameters A, B, and C, are in the back of the textbook in the appendix. And so we draw this typical approximate Raoult's law behavior, and we know that we're starting at 50 degrees C in this composition, and the pressure here is fixed at 0.75 atmospheres, and we are going to raise the temperature at constant pressure in order to do the evaporation. And we're completely evaporated once we get to the dew point. And so the question is, what is the temperature of the dew point? Because we're going to really need that in order to solve this problem. And so to do that, we will do a dew point calculation, and we'll just take advantage of Raoult's law here, which applies for our ideal gas, ideal solution conditions in our phase equilibrium problem. And so we can write down Raoult's law for our dew point calculation. Our dew point temperature. All right, so that will be YA times P is equal to the mole fraction in the liquid phase times the saturation pressure at the dew point temperature. All right, we can write the same relationship for component B, where in this case we have the saturation pressure or vapor pressure for water at the dew point temperature. And now what we can do is rearrange this equation. This is the most convenient way to solve these kind of problems, and realize that we can make use of the relation that xA plus xB is equal to 1. If we solve these two equations for xA and xB and rearrange the equation that we get by plugging those values into this equation, then what we get is that pressure is equal to 1 over YA over PA sat plus YB over PB sat. All right, and in this case, these again are functions of the dew point temperature. All right, this pressure is known as 0.75 atmospheres. YA is equal to 0.6 at the dew point. YB is equal to 0.4. And so what we can do is guess the temperature, use Antoine's relations to solve for PA sat and PB sat, and then see if when we evaluate this side of the equation, we get 0.75. If we don't, then we go back and guess a new value for the temperature and keep iterating until we get this pressure equal to 0.75 atmospheres. All right, and that's how we'll find the dew point temperature. We'll get the dew point temperature to be some value. And now the question is, how do we use this to solve for our Q value, which is equal to delta H, which is equal to the enthalpy of the final state minus the enthalpy of the initial state? And what we can recognize here is that the final state is an ideal gas, and we have very simple relationships to use for working with an ideal gas. And so we can set this delta H equal to the ideal gas change, and this will integrate from the initial T of 50 degrees C to the final temperature that we would evaluate in this problem through iteration, which is the temperature of the dew point. And in addition to that, so that will tell us basically the ideal gas enthalpy change in going from 50 degrees C to the dew point temperature. But at 50 degrees C, we don't have an ideal gas. We have an ideal solution that is a liquid. And in that ideal solution, that liquid will have a departure from the enthalpy value of the ideal gas. And so we can write that departure function as being equal to the true enthalpy at condition 1 minus the enthalpy of the ideal gas at condition 1. And unfortunately, we can use charts or just use PREOS. And all we have to do for each of our components, water and benzene, right, is go to PREOS.xls, use that program. This is evaluated at state 1, so we know that condition actually. And it's a temperature of 50 degrees C and a pressure of 0.75 atmospheres. And then with the known critical properties and heat capacity for benzene and water that are available in the PREOS spreadsheet, then we can actually solve for both of these terms within that spreadsheet. All right, but the question is, how do we do this for a mixture? And in fact, the way that we'll get the total delta H, this will be the delta H for the ith component. All right, so we'll do that for both benzene and we'll do it for water. Right, and so because we have an ideal solution, then delta H will just be delta H for the benzene, component A, times the mole fraction of benzene. And I'll write this in this case as a Z, indicating the total bulk fraction, and that's a 0.6, plus ZB for water of 0.4 times delta H evaluated from this expression for water. So this will have a subscript of I to denote that it depends on whether it's water or benzene. And this also will have a subscript of I, because the departure functions will be different for benzene and water because they have different critical properties. And so by evaluating these expressions using the spreadsheet and plugging them in here, we can calculate the total delta H and thus the total Q. And again, we can do that because we do have an ideal solution. An ideal solution, the delta H is equal to the delta H's as if each component were acting independently. We can use the pure component properties when we're calculating ideal solution changes of state. But as we'll start doing more, and we'll have to take into account the fact that you can have enthalpy changes of mixing if we don't have an ideal solution.